encourage you are strong. I want everybody to join in saying konnichiwa.
Konnichiwa.
And I want all my Japanese friends to say kemcho. Kemcho. Yasui sensei. Kemcho. So konnichiwa kemcho. Because this is all about a sister city relationship between the design city of Asia, which has got its unique reputation, name, fame, and goodwill, the city of Kobe, and Ahmedabad, which is India's first heritage city. So we are very delighted to celebrate on this occasion this first economic cooperation seminar being held between Kobe and Ahmedabad. And that is why, first and foremost, let us start this seminar with a warm round of applause in commemoration and celebration of our wonderful relationship. And friends, I feel extremely proud and delighted as the president of the Indo-Japan Friendship Association of Gujarat and the former president of the Ahmedabad Management Association, and also as founder and coordinator of the Japan Information and Study Center here in Ahmedabad, to give a very warm welcome to all our delegates who have come here, led by the Honorable Mayor of Kobe, Mr. Kizo Hisamoto. Give him a big round of applause. Hisamoto-san, yokoso Ahmedabad, yokoso Gujarat. We're very, very happy to extend a very warm and cordial welcome. We're also very, very delighted to welcome amidst us the chairman of the Kobe City Assembly, a very prestigious body. We are delighted to have amidst us, you know, he's so busy with his official proceedings, he's here with us just for 24 hours. But nonetheless, he's with us, and that's a great symbol of our strong bonds of friendship and goodwill. Friends, let us put our hands together for Mr. Kazuhiko Adachi, the Honorable Chair of the Kobe City Assembly. And we are wanting to also on this occasion welcome our very distinguished delegates of the business mission. So while we start, let us extend our floral welcome as well. May I invite the chairman of our Economic Cooperation Council, Mr. Yatindra Sharma, to please present a bouquet of flowers to the Honorable Mayor, Mr. Hisamoto. Kizo Hisamoto. No, no. It's okay. Let's do it here, right under the tower of Kobe. And I would also like our chairman of the Economic Cooperation Council, Mr. Sharma, to present flowers to the Honorable Chair of the Kobe City Assembly, Mr. Adachi. Honorable Mr. Adachi. I would like to, on this occasion, friends, welcome a very strong business delegation, a delegation of the members of the Kobe City Assembly and also academic leaders from the city of Kobe. Just imagine 15 members from the Ahmedabad city going to Kobe in December 2019 after the signing of the sister city agreement took place between the Honorable Mayor of Kobe and the Honorable Ambassador of India, His Excellency Mr. Verma, in the august presence of the Honorable Prime Minister of India in June 2019. So to further the friendship, 15 of us went. Friends, if you go in 15 and imagine if the number gets reversed and you get a response, it means that is one of the strongest foundation that is laid down for the relationship. We were 15 who went with our mayor, Ms. Bijal Patel, and Mayor Hisamoto has brought 51 of them from Kobe. 51. So Hisamoto-san, thank you very much. Let our friendship grow this strong. Thank you so much. We would like to welcome the leader of the business mission, and I would invite Mr. Sandeep Shah to please come here and present flowers to Mr. Toshihiro Horiuchi, the leader of the business mission and the director of Kamigumi Company Limited. Welcome, Mr. Horiuchi. And may I invite Mr. Dharmendra Mishra to please come forward and present flowers to Mr. Katsunori Hosokawa, the deputy leader of the business mission. Hosokawa-san. We are also very delighted to have in this august audience the, you know, one of our finest memories here in this very hall began, I would say, how many, almost close to 9 years, 10 years ago, Toyofuku-san?
Yeah, I think the
2011.
Yes.
Friends, that is when JETRO Ahmedabad was founded. And they decided that Ahmedabad is a very important destination. So we had a JETRO in New Delhi and JETRO in Mumbai. But then JETRO Ahmedabad came to be established, and we were very happy to have a very dynamic director. We call him as the founder director of JETRO Ahmedabad, and he is none else but Mr. Kenichiro Toyofuku. And I would request, in fact, I would myself want to revive. I would invite him here because it was on this day that I gave him a very warm hug.
Yes, yes, yes. Thank you very much.
I want to welcome you here. In fact, I'm obliged to Honorable Mayor Hisamoto for making I'm obliged to Mayor Hisamoto for actually recommending Toyofuku-san's name for this seminar today. So a special thanks to you, because he has been so busy in New Delhi. We always thought he was very busy, but I think you have got the right man. And Toyofuku-san, you will remember standing up here on this very podium in 2011, you had said, very soon there will be more than 50 companies, Japanese companies in Gujarat. Actually, what you said today has come out true in more than double the number, because Gujarat has got more than 100 Japanese companies. So we are absolutely delighted. We're very, very happy to have you. And I would like to, on this occasion, because JETRO has always played a pioneering role. He was like the founder of JETRO Ahmedabad. We have in this mission the chief director of the Japan External Trade Organization, Mr. Minoru Arahata, who is here, and I would request Alpesh Parikh, if he is here, to please come forward, or Mr. Jigar Patel. Yes, Alpesh has just gone out to receive the Consul General. Please present flowers, Jigar, to Arahata-san, who is also going to make a very beautiful presentation. And friends, we are going to have a very special, inspirational presentation of a real success story of a Japanese SME, small and medium enterprise. You know, we hear success stories of Suzuki, Hitachi, Toyota. Of course, they are very important. But the success story of a small and medium enterprise is something very unique. And we are privileged that we are going to have a presentation on this subject by the chairman of a very dynamic Indo-Japanese joint venture, Fuji Silver Tea Concrete Private Limited, Mr. Shunsuke Irie. I would request Irie-san, please come. Please come here. Irie-san, you joined us a little late, so I'm sorry. But please come here, accept our flowers, and I would request, we have so many of you. Mr. Deven Patel will come, because he is also a rock star in terms of setting up a very nice venture here. You will welcome Irie-san of Fuji Silver Tech Concrete Private Limited, please. Irie-san, would you please take a seat? We're very happy to have you. We are just waiting, but I'll do that later, for the Consul General. Let me wrap up this few opening remarks, because now comes the real time for which we are all waiting for. Waiting for a lovely presentation to the companies here from Ahmedabad and Gujarat. A presentation coming from the Honorable Mayor of Kobe. And I only want to tell two things, one to him and one to the audience. Sir, you'll be very happy to know that in this auditorium today, you have evinced, Kobe, the 51 delegates have evinced excited participation of nearly 200 delegates who have come from all over Ahmedabad and Gujarat. And our dear Consul General comes at the right time. Please, Harada-san, Harada-san, Harada-san. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, you are so dear to us. You have come at the right time. We want to give flowers and a very warm hug to you for all your dear time. Friends, just imagine what happens when everything is favorable. You have a lovely Ahmedabad-Kobe sister city relationship. You have very dynamic JETROs both in Kobe and in Ahmedabad supporting the business environment. And above all, you have such a dynamic Consul General of Japan in Mumbai, Friends, Mr. Michio Harada, we want to give him a very warm round of applause. In fact, he has literally rushed from Mumbai for us. I'm aware of it, sir. Thank you so much, leaving so many important engagements. And I want to tell the members of the Kobe Mission that he's going to be with us here today and tomorrow, exclusively, only for your support and for our mission. So we are very, very happy. And sir, I want to tell you, as you were entering, I said, we have more than 200 delegates who have participated at this business seminar. And we want to now invite the Honorable Mayor of Kobe, Mr. Hisamoto. But friends, let me tell you, when I sent him the invitation and request, his interpreter virtually sent me a googly. Mr. Leo Luchuk, he said, Patel-san, the mayor of Kobe, because normally presentations are made in Japanese and then translated in English. But he said, the mayor of Kobe will make a presentation in English. Just imagine, friends, what a wonderful gesture. And the gesture comes because he said, I want to save time. I want that the maximum deliberations take place. I think he deserves one more round of applause as I request him to please come here. Hisamoto-san, dozo.
PPT? 今日はあの大変内容が盛りだくさんで、時間が限られているということで、さらに時間がさらに短縮されることになりましたので、あの私から英語で説明をし、神戸からの皆さんがよくご存知の概括的な内容、儀礼的部分は省略をしながら日本語で補足させていただきたいと思います。 Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Kizo Hisamoto, the mayor of Kobe City. First of all, please allow me to say what a great honor it is to speak at this seminar todayI would like to begin by expressing my deep gratitude to Mr. Harada Michio, Consul General of Japan in Mumbai. And I would also like to extend my heartfelt gratitude to Mr. Mukesh Patel, President of the Indo-Japan Friendship Association Gujarat, for his tireless support in terms of organizing this seminar.Today, we are delighted to visit Ahmedabad together with a business mission from Kobe led by Mr. Horiuchi Toshihiro, as well as Adachi Kazuhiko, Chair of the Kobe City Assembly, Mr. Yasui Toshihiko, Chair of the Kobe City Assembly India-Japan Friendship Association, and many other members of our City Assembly,all together comprising a 50-person strong delegation. Now I'd like to take some time to briefly introduce our city. Kobe is an international city that developed as Japan's gateway to the world. The population of Kobe is about 1.52 million, and Kobe is ranked sixth among all cities in Japan in terms of the GDP.I'd like to briefly touch on the history of our city. After the port of Kobe was opened to the world in 1868, our city had developed around it, becoming a major industrial center of Western Japan. The city flourished with many shipyards and steel mills, and even today we have numerous warehousing and machine building companies. Kobe has also developedindustrial spirit, and thanks to this, there is a great number of foreign residents in our city, representing over 140 countries and regions around the world. As a city that has been home to many foreign residents over the years, Kobe now boasts many places of worship and international schools, making it a city of choice for many people and companies from all over the groups. Moreover, while it is a major city, Kobe is surrounded by rich nature, and since we are also close to both the mountains and the sea, you can enjoy the beauty of every season right within the city limits. Our city also has an abundance of delicacies, events, and sightseeing spots, including the Arima Hot Springs, one of the three oldest hot spring resorts in Japan. It is my sincere hope that everyone in attendance will have a chance to visit Kobe, and I look forward to welcoming each and every one of you to our city. Furthermore, I am delighted to say that Kobe has a very long history of exchanges with India as well. For instance, our city is home to the India Club, which was established in Kobe over a century ago. There are also over 1,000 people from India currently living in the city. Additionally, Kobe is also the host city of India Mela, the biggest Indian festival in all of Western Japan. Last year marked the 10th time this festival was held in Kobe, and our citizens are eagerly looking forward to it every year. Finally, in 2018, we have hosted an international yoga day celebration every right next to the Kobe Port Tower, which attracted over 1,000 participants. When His Excellency Prime Minister Modi visited Kobe in November 2016, the Hyogo Prefectural Government signed a memorandum of understanding on mutual cooperation with the state of Gujarat. His Excellency visited our city again last June, and at this time, we were able to sign a letter of intent on the promotion of economic exchange between Ahmedabad and Kobe. Following the signing of this letter of intent, we had the pleasure of receiving Mayor Vijay Patel and Mr. Mukesh Patel in Kobe last December, and we used this opportunity to discuss the future of our cooperation. And finally, today, Mayor Patel and I had another great opportunity to discuss the promotion of economic exchanges between our cities. We intend to make good use of this visit to deepen our exchanges across a wide range of fields, and we would greatly appreciate your kind support in this manner. Kobe とアーメダバートの関係について少し触れさせていただきました。神戸は100年以上前からの歴史があるインディアクラブがありまして、1000人もの方々が今神戸で暮らしておられます。インディアメーラーは西日本最大のインドのお祭りで毎年開催されています。昨年は10回目ということになりました。で、おととしには国際ヨガデーのイベントを開催し、神戸タワーバックに1000人を超える方々のヨガが実施をされました。2016年11月のモディ首相が神戸に来られましたとき、兵庫県とグジャラート州が覚書を締結をいたしました。神戸市も2019年6月、6月にモディ首相が来られたときに、アーメダバード市との経済交流を促進するための意思確認書を交換をいたしました。昨年の12月には、ビジャール・パテル市長、ムケシュ・パテル・グジャラート協会 会長が神戸にお越しになり、今回の交流について協議をし、今回の訪問につながったわけです。Next, I'd like to introduce our innovation and startup ecosystem.Our city strives to develop the local economy, but at the same time, we also want to exert a positive influence on the entire country, and thus in 2016, we partnered with 500 startups, one of the most active venture funds and seed accelerators in the world, to carry out an acceleration program called 500 Kobe Accelerator. Now I am certain that many of you have heard about GovTech.This term usually refers to improving citizen services through the use of cutting-edge technology. Kobe is actually one of the forerunners in this field in Japan. We have already achieved very good results with one of our projects called Urban Innovation Kobe. Because of this, we have started hosting an event called GovTech Summit since 2019. Kobe はスタートアップのエコシステムに力を入れています。2016年からは世界で最もアクティブなシード投資ファンドである500スタートアップスをパートナーに迎え、500神戸アクセラレーターを実施をしています。GovTech という市民サービスを先進的なテクノロジーの力でより良いものにする取り組みを行っておりまして、この分野での先駆的な役割を果たしています。The 500 Kobe Accelerator is carried out by our municipal government in cooperation with a major venture capital firm in order to support promising entrepreneurs in cutting-edge fields. In 2018, 237 startups companies applied to participate in this program. And since more than half of them were from outside Japan, including India,It is evident that this program is widely recognized all over the world. All in all, over the last 3 years, 56 companies have participated in the program, and they have collectively acquired over 7.7 billion yen investments. 500 Kobe Accelerator Program は、シリコンバレーのベンチャーキャピタルと自治体が連携して実施する。我が国でも先駆的な起業家支援プログラムです。2018年には237社の応募がありましたが、海外からの応募が半数を上回るなど、国際的に認知されたプログラムになっています。インドからの応募もありました。3年間で56のスタートアップが参加し、プログラム終了後に合計77億円の資金調達にも成功しています。Next, let me introduce the Urban Innovation Kobe Program.This program provides a framework for startup companies to work together with city officials to try and solve various problems faced by the city government. This enables the city government to make use of different know-hows available to startup companies while providing them with valuable experience of cooperation with a large municipality as well as a chance to test their own products and services.Since the establishment of this program, we were able to extend support to 14 startup companies, and they succeeded in solving every 3 out of 4 challenges that they chose to work on. Urban Innovation Kobe は、神戸市の行政が抱えている課題を、スタートアップと神戸市の職員が一緒に解決をする仕組みです。このプログラムで、神戸はスタートアップのノウハウを取り組みつつ、諸課題の解決が可能となり、参加したスタートアップは、神戸で自社のサービスや商品を展開する実験を行うことができます。行政の抱える課題の4分の3が解決され、14社のスタートアップを支援をすることができました。Next, I would like to introduce the Kobe Biomedical Innovation Cluster. Started back in 1998,Over the years, this project has grown to become the largest biomedical cluster in Japan, now boasting approximately 370 companies and research institutions that collectively have around 11,000 employees. This accumulation of companies and research institutes is constantly generating new business opportunities and innovation.The cluster is managed by the Foundation for Biomedical Research and Innovation at Kobe, and the president of this organization, Dr. Tatsuku Honjo, received the 2018 Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine, which was indeed the most welcome news to us all. 神戸は医療産業都市を推進をしております。我が国最大級のバイオメディカルクラスターとして成長をしてきました。1998年にスタートをいたしまして、現在1万1000名もの方々が働いており、約370社の企業研究所が立地する、日本でも最大のクラスターに成長しています。新規ビジネスやさまざまなイノベーションを創出しています。ノーベル生理学・医学賞を受賞された本庄佑理事長にリードをしていただいております。The Kobe Biomedical Innovation Cluster features three separate areas.Commonly known as bio, medical, and simulation clusters. The institutions in each of these areas have different functions, But all together, they create the perfect environment for innovation in the medical field. The cluster spans roughly 1.50 kilometers north to south and about 1 kilometer from east to west, thus creating a well-integrated area with numerous universities, medical companies, as well as research and healthcare institutions in one place. 神戸医療産業都市は、バイオメクラスター、メディカルクラスター、シミュレーションクラスターという3つのエリアから構成されておりまして、それぞれのエリアの機能が融合することで、医療イノベーションを生み出すことが目指しています。狭い範囲に大学研究機関や医療機関、医療関連企業が集積する、非常にコンパクトな構成となっています。Lastly, please allow me to introduce our Hydrogen Smart City Initiative, which aims to produce innovation in the energy field. Within the framework of this initiative, we are currently working on two groundbreaking projects in cooperation with various private companies. The first of these takes place on our artificial port island, where we have for the first time in the world, successfully supplied an urban area with heat and electricity generated solely using hydrogen fuel. The second aims to establish a comprehensive hydrogen supply chain between Australia and Kobe in order to transport, unload, and store liquefied hydrogen derived from Australian brown coal, also known as Australia's unused energy, on the Kobe Airport Island. In this regard, it is worth nothing that just last month we had a launching ceremony for the world's first liquid hydrogen freight ship at the Kawasaki Heavy Industries Kobe Works. 最後に紹介するのは、神戸のエネルギー分野でのイノベーション、水素スマートシティ神戸構想です。2つのプロジェクトが動き始めました。一つは世界で初めて市街地で水素燃料 100% でエネルギー供給を実現をする実証実験。二つ目はオーストラリアの未利用エネルギーである褐炭から液化水素を製造し、神戸空港島まで結ぶ貯蔵、輸送、利用までが一体となった液化水素サプライチェーンの構築を目指す実証事業です。昨年の12月には、世界で初となる水素運搬船の進水式が川崎重工神戸工場で行われました。This concludes my short introduction to our city. I strongly believe that this seminar will be a splendid opportunity for Indian businesses to develop real ties with the businesses from our city, and I urge you to make good use of this opportunity. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. The way in which we have been introduced to dynamic city of Kobe, where Hisamoto-san talked about some of the very, very interesting elements for our business people in Gujarat. It is gateway to the world, very rightly said by you. We had privilege to visit that city, and we had that feel all throughout time when we spent our time in Kobe city. Also, it is industrial hub of Japan. Talking about startup economy, again, Kobe has got a leadership where they talk about creating more than 500 plus startups and backed by innovation center. I mean, a very perfect complement which has been created. Also, we learnt about new ways of generating electricity through hydrogen. And in all, we had wonderful exposition of Kobe City and their business activities. And thank you, sir, for giving us such a wonderful information. May I request all of you to give him a big round of applause. Thank you very much, sir. Now we would like to invite
I talked about Mr. Kenichiro Toyofuku, as I mentioned, who has been our friend, philosopher, and guide since the business collaborations with Gujarat started almost a decade ago with great vibrancy. Please. Friends, a special round of applause for Toyofuku-san.
Thank you very much, Mukesh Patel-san, President of the... Hisamoto-sama, Mayor of the Kobe City, and Adachi-sama, Chair of the Kobe City Assembly, and Harada-sama, and Councillor General of Mumbai, Japan, and it is a great, powerful promoter of the Mukesh Patel-san, of the President of India-Japan Friendship Association. I'm great honor to invite this very, very important function. And I think the time was very, very limited. So that's why I'd like to explain India and Japan, Japanese, English and Japanese mixed together. And first of all, and this time, just before this seminar, I met the Hisamoto-san, mayor of the Kobe City. Then I heard the purpose of this visit. And in future, mayor of the Hisamoto-san would like to promote the business between Kobe City and Ahmedabad, the private companies. So that's why my role of this speech is how to promote the business between Kobe City and Ahmedabad. 本日はお話をさせていただく機会をいただきましてありがとうございます。先ほど、神戸市長と若干お話をさせていただく機会がございまして、その時にですね、将来的にはこのアーメダバードと神戸市の間でですね、ビジネスを、具体的なビジネスを支援していきたいというご意向だということをお伺いしましたので、そういった意味からですね、この両市のですね、ビジネスがプロモートの協力していくようなお話をさせていただければというふうに思っております。Let me introduce my experience in India. Now, totally, I live in India for 14 years from 2004. Then, initially, I'm working for the Embassy of Japan, New Delhi. And after that, I'm working for JETRO, Japan External Trade Organization.Then during my stay in JETRO, for 3 years, I was stationed in Ahmedabad. So at that time, I think the only 5 Japanese people living in Ahmedabad. Then I'm very happy. Now I heard more than 300 Japanese people is living in Ahmedabad. 若干自己紹介をさせていただきますと、私14年間インドで仕事をさせていただいております。最初はニューデリーの日本大使館で仕事をさせていただいておりまして、その次にジェトロで仕事をさせていただきました。ジェトロで仕事をしている間ですね、3年間はここのアーメダバードに駐在をさせていただきまして、当時最初にアーメダバードに駐在をした際には日本人の駐在員はアーメダバードに5人しかいなかったんですけれども、今現在は聞くとこによりますと300人以上の日本人の方がこのアーメダバードで生活をされているというふうに聞いております。で、もう一点でございますが、私は昨年からインドのマルチスズキの方に移りまして、現在はマルチスズキの方で仕事をさせていただいております。で、私の14年間ですね、 おそらく300社以上の日本企業の方とお会いをさせていただきまして、どうやってインドに進出をするのか、インドでビジネスをしてどんな問題点があるのかということをご相談をさせていただき、またアドバイスをさせていただきながら仕事をさせてきておりました。そういった観点からですね、私のこれまでの経験を踏まえまして、どういった形でインドとのビジネスを進める上で何がポイントなのかということをですね、お話ししたいと思っております。And I have the experience for 14 years. I think the more than 300 Japanese companies, I suggested and consult them how to start the business between India and how to solve the issue and the problem in India for Japanese companies. So from my experience, I would like to explain what is the key elementto start the business between India and Japan. Then I'd like to mention the three topics, how to promote the business between India and Japan. 3つの点についてですね、非常に重要な点をお話をさせていただければと思っております。1つ目の点で最も重要な点でございますけれども、これはインドはなかなか日本から見ると、ハードルが高いというかビジネスが難しい国だというふうに思われておりまして、それで事実ですね、インドで苦戦をされている企業の方多いのは事実でございますが、私が今までお会いした中、経験から申し上げるとですね、やはり日本の中小企業の方、特に規模の小さい方に、実は意外や意外よりビジネスのチャンスがたくさんあるというのが私の経験でございます。一般的にはですね、難しい国に進出をする際には、資本力のあって人材が豊富な大企業の方がチャンスがあると思われているところが多いんですけれども、インドにつきましては比較的小さい規模の日本の中小企業の方のチャンスが非常に広がっているというのが私の経験でございます。 Now I'd like to let me introduceThe most important key factor to start the business between India and Japan is the size of the companies, especially in the Japanese side. The most of the case are from the Japanese company's point of view, the business in India is very, very difficult compared to China and the Southeast Asia. But from my experience, I thinkSmall and medium-sized Japanese companies have the more chance to start the business in India. あの一つのですね、事例をご説明させていただければと思っておりますが、私がアーメダバードに駐在をしまして、2012年だったと思いますけれども、それまでインドにはですね、おそらくほとんど一社も日本の中小企業さんというのはこちらで工場を立ち上げたり本格的なビジネスをされていなかった状況でございますけれども、その時にですね、今まで日本でしかビジネスをされていなくて、日本でしか工場をお持ちでなくて、海外にまだ進出をしたことがないという企業様がいらっしゃいまして、それで世界初めての進出でこのアーメダバードにチャレンジをされたいという経営者の方これも来られました。実はこの会場にいらっしゃっていてですね、もしよろしければご紹介いただきたいんですけれども、豊田実さんと言われるもう本当に優秀な社長さんでございまして、世界初進出でこのアーメダバードにいらっしゃった方でございます。豊田さん、もしよろしかったら Yeah, he's the Mr. Minoru Toyoda. He's the chairman and the CEO of the Japanese middle-sized companies. But before coming to India, Toyoda Minoru-san have the factories only in Japan, 100% domestic Japanese companies. Then in 2012, I will meet Toyoda-san, and Toyoda-san,met me, and he would like to start the challenge to establish the manufacturing hub in Ahmedabad. But before that, he doesn't have the factories in other countries. This is the first trial for him to set up the factories in foreign countries. This destination was the Ahmedabad. Then I think the Toyoda-san, chairman, CEO himself, more almost all every week or every month or every 2 weeks, he visiting the Ahmedabad by himself. And he set up the factories in Ahmedabad. And I think the currently, this is my memory is correct. Now I think that Toyoda-san have the 3 factories in Gujarat. So this is a very, very great examples. Then I think from my observation, I think the small and the medium-sized Japanese companies have the great chance to start the business in India. 先ほど豊田工機の豊田社長をご紹介させていただいたんですけれども、2012年に私アーメダバードに勤務をいたしまして、それまで中小企業の方でインドに進出をされている方ほとんどいらっしゃらなかったんですが、その中で今までは日本にしか生産拠点を持っていなかった豊田工機さんがですね、世界初進出でアーメダバードに進出をされたいというご相談をいただきまして、それから社長ご自身がですね、おそらく毎月というか2週間に1度ぐらい現地をご自分で訪問されまして、会社の設立、あとはパートナーとなるインド人の右腕になる方を探すところから一から積み上げられまして、おそらく今現在ではですね、3つぐらいの会社というか工場をこちらで運営をされていて、非常にですね、業績もいいというふうにお伺いをしております。そういった意味で、詳細の説明はなかなかお時間ございませんが、大きい会社だけではなくてですね、日本の場合にはこの中小企業の方々、こういった方々の方がむしろインドのビジネスをスタートするのに馴染みやすいんじゃないかと、非常に合ってるんじゃないかという一つの事例でございます。そういった意味でですね、特に今回神戸市からいらっしゃった方々の中にも中小企業の方がたくさんいらっしゃると思いますし、おそらく今回参加されなかった方々の中にもおそらく神戸の中小企業の方はたくさんいらっしゃると思いますが、実は難易度が高いと思われているインドのビジネスでございますけれども、中小企業の方の方がよりビジネスチャンスがあるんだということがですね、まず一番最初に重要なポイントかなというふうに思っております。Let me introduce the second key factor, how to start the business between Ahmedabad and Kobe and between India and Japan. And the second one which product and which service is suit for Indian market. So this deep thinking and the selection is a second important factor, I think, to start the business between India and Japan. 2点目でございますけれども、やはり日本の企業の方から見てですね、2つ目に重要な点は、インドに合った製品技術、インドのマーケットに求められているサービス、これが何かということの見極めがですね、非常に重要なのかなというのが2点目でございます。インドはですね、私日印の仕事をさせていただいておりまして、つくづく実感をしておりますが、日本にいながらにして得られるインドの情報というのは非常に限られておりまして、実はインドの実態をなかなか示していないところが多いのが実情でございます。そういった限られた情報の中で、なかなかインドに合った製品、この製品がインドで売れるのかどうか、このサービスがインド人受け入れられるのかどうか、こういったことを見極めるのが非常に難しくて、このですね、どういった製品サービスがインドに受け入れられるのか、インドのマーケットに合ってるのか、これの見極めがですね、2つ目として非常に重要なところかなというふうに感じております。 もう一点ご説明をしますと、インドについての日本における情報はですね、どうしてもデリーですとかムンバイ、あとはバンガロール、チェンナイ、カルカッタといった大都市の情報がすごく多いのが事実でございます。それはメディアがですね、こういった大都市に駐在をしていて、なかなかこういった大都市以外の、まあ、農村部の情報を拾えないっていうのが事実でございますけれども、実は人口の分布を見ますと、おそらく都市部に住んでらっしゃる方は全体の大体2割か3割ぐらい、7割8割の方はですね、インドの農村に住んでらっしゃる方でございます。大体人口にしますと農村が10億、都市部が3億というバランスでございます。圧倒的に人口で見ますと農村部が多いというのが現状でございまして、最近のインドの経済を見ますと、まあ、5年前に比べますと、まあ、経済成長にしても若干踊り場に来ておりまして、現在 5% 程度の成長で若干成長率が低下をしておりますが、このいろんな実情を聞くとですね、都市部のインドの企業の方、この方がですね、特に最近経済の減速傾向を感じられているのが多いのかなというのが私の実感でございます。一方でですね、インドの農村部、私はインドの農村を歩くのが趣味でございまして、これまでおそらく数百の村を歩いてまいりましたが、インドの農村はですね、最近非常に劇的な変化を遂げておりまして、オートバイを買ったり、テレビを買ったり、携帯を買ったりということで、経済活動が始まっております。そういった中で、この10億の農村部の方々、こういった方々に合ったような製品、サービス、これがですね、おそらく将来、インドで、おそらくビジネスをする上で非常に重要な製品なりサービスになるのかなというのが私の実感でございます。Let me introduce in English. And in the second point, what is important is how to select the technology and the product and the service to suit for the Indian market. This is very important factor to start a business between India and Japan. This is my personal observation.Now, currently, I think the last 15 years, Indian economic development is mostly happen in the metropolitan city and the big cities. I think this is my personal observation. I think, for example, the Delhi and the Mumbai. This is, I think, the economic development ratio is, I think, more than 10% for the last 20 years.But unfortunately, last 2-3 years, I think the economic development of India is slowing down. The most of the reason, I think that in the big cities, business development is decreasing. Instead of this, I personally like to visit the local villages in all over the India, especially in Gujarat. End of this year, also, I visited the village of Chota Udaipur district.And Hansalpur district and Surendranagar district, like this. Then every year I'm visiting the villages in all over the India. Then I come to know the difference. Before that, the income of the village people is mostly come from the agriculture activities only. That's why I think the general income of the village people was very, very limited. But currently,Most of the farmers started the business except from the agriculture. Then they can afford to buy the two-wheelers and the mobile phones and the TV set also. That's why in future, Japanese companies should focusing on the product and the service. This is capture the market in the village and the local rural economies in India.This is my second suggestion. So that's why I think that in today's reception and the many opportunity, Indian companies can interact with the Japanese delegation. I think that by themselves also the companies, and they have the many friend and the related companies in Kobe cities, then you can discuss what product and what serviceWith acceptable for Indian market. Such types of discussion will be the good starting point to start the business between Kobe and Ahmedabad. This is the second point. Mukesh, time is okay? Okay. This is the second point. And the third point, this one also very, very important point. And the most of the Japanese people did not understand this factor. And the third point is the location of the office, location of the local partner in India. Most of the case, Japanese people knows about Delhi, Mumbai, Bangalore, Chennai, such types of metropolitan city. But from my experience, I think that it is very, very difficult to find a good partner in such types of metropolitan city. Instead of this, I think that Ahmedabad is the one of the best cities to find a good partner in all over the India. I think that this is the seminar between the Ahmedabad and the Kobe, but not because of this. I personally believe, I think that Ahmedabad is one of the best cities to find a good partner in India.3つ目に非常に重要な要素でございますけれども、それはインドといっても27の州がございまして、非常に地理的にも広い州国でございます。それで州ごとに文化もビジネスカルチャーも違う中でですね、どこの州、どこの都市に拠点を設けるのか、あとはどこの州、どこの都市のインド企業とパートナーを組むのか、というのが非常に重要な要素になってまいります。一般的に日本におりますと、インドの都市というとですね、デリー、ムンバイ、コルカタ、チェンナイ、バンガロールという大都市を想定されることが多いんですが、私の今までの経験から申し上げるとですね、こういったデリー、ムンバイですとか、こういった大都市は非常に競争が厳しくて、いろんなインドの方が、企業の方がいらっしゃるもんですから、実は適切なパートナー、あとは本当に右腕となるインド人の、一緒に何て言いますか、働いてくれるスタッフを見つけるのに非常に苦労されている企業が多いのが事実でございます。一方でですね、私このアーメダバードで3年仕事をさせていただきましたが、実はアーメダバードの会社とパートナーで、スタートされた日本企業の方々、あとはアーメダバードでその会社の中の、一緒にですね、共同で経営をして、くれるようなインド人のスタッフを探された日本企業の方々、こういった方は非常にうまくいっているケースが多いのが事実でございます。言ってみればデリーですとかムンバイですとか、そういったところでパートナーを組まれたり、そこで、企業のマネージメントを行う、インド人の方を見つけられた方々中にはですね、かなりいろんな日本人では想像がつかないような難しい問題を抱えている企業の方々たくさんいらっしゃるんですが、そういった意味でアーメダバードの方々は他の大都市に比べますと非常にいい方々、信頼できる方々、信頼できる企業の割合が高いのかなというのが私の実感でございます。おそらくですね、アーメダバードはムンバイ、デリーに比べますと、おそらく外国企業の出てきている数もおそらく少ないと思います。そういった意味でですね、インドの企業の方から見ますと、やはり外国から来てくれた企業を大切にしていただけるというところがありますし、あとはですね、やはり人間といたしましても、デリーとかムンバイはインドのさまざまな地方から皆さんがもう移り住んできまして、文化的にも非常にミックスされたカルチャーでございますけれども、アーメダバードはですね、まだ州の他の人の人口がまだまだ少なくて、このアーメダバード自体のいい文化がですね、まだまだ残っている都市でございます。そういった意味で非常に信頼できるパートナーを見つけるという観点から、実はアーメダバードというのは一番いい都市なのかなというふうに考えております。お時間も限られておりますので、以上がですね、この をビジネスを進める上で3点重要な点ということでございまして、まあ、一つはインドに合った技術サービスをどう探していくのかと、あとは企業の会社の規模は大きくなくても中小でもチャンスがあるということ、あと3つ目は拠点とするんであればパートナーを見つけるんであればアーメダバードというのが非常に適切であることをご説明をいたしましたが、それではどうやって一番最初にあのビジネスを始める前にですね活動を始めたらいいかということを一つだけ最後にアドバイスをさせていただいて終わりにしたいと思っております。なかなか最初からですねあの多額な投資をして会社を設立したり工場を立ち上げるというのは各社さんなかなかリスクが高くて難しいと思います。私のですね一つアドバイスはもしできればこのアーメダバードのインド人の方々にいい方を見つけていただいて、おそらく2人ができれば3人ぐらいがいいんですけれども、その方に日本語をですね半年ぐらい勉強していただいて、それで神戸にある自分の会社でまず一緒に雇っていただいて、アーメダバードのインド人の方々と日本で一緒に働いていただくと、こういったのがですねまずインドの方を理解する上で、あとはインド進出の戦略を一緒にディスカッションする上で、あとはインドのことを理解する上でですね一番最初のステップとしてリスクなくですねまず最初のステップとしてしやすい活動なのではないかなというふうに思っているところでございます。と最後英語でご説明させていただきます。 And this three key point. First one is the size of the company. Small and medium sized Japanese companies have the more chance compared to the big companies. And the second one is I think thesecond one is how to select the technology and the product to suit for Indian market is very important. And the third one is location. And Ahmedabad is the big city to start the business in India. Then I think I suggested to Japanese companies how to proceed the steps, how to start theActivities before starting the business in India is my suggestion is first find the two or three Indian good young engineer and the staff and educate them the Japanese language for 6 months. After that, Japanese companies in Kobe should hire these two or three Ahmedabad people in Japan. Then they can start the discussionhow to start the business between India and Japan, and how to make strategies in Indian market. I think that to hire the two, three Indian person could be the first step to proceed the business, to start the business between India and Japan. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Toyofuku-san, for your very valuable and experienced advice. You know, I think which both the Indian and Japanese entrepreneurs would very much appreciate. Friends, I am very happy to welcome Amit Stas. In fact, today there have been so many parallel events here in Gujarat on the Japanese front that the industries commissioner who was to be with us is currently at the Chief Minister's office having a meeting with the Ambassador of Japan. But we are happy to have his deputy from the Industrial Extension Bureau, Mr. Paresh Painoli, and I would request him to please come, and we would like to offer him flowers as a gesture of welcome. So Mr. Painoli is going to be later showing a small film on the industrial opportunities in Gujarat, and he will also be happy to take the questions from the Kobe delegates with the help of the interpreters on the business opportunities in Ahmedabad. In the meanwhile, I would like to request the Honorable Consul General of Japan in Mumbai, Mr. Michio Harada, to extend his greetings on this occasion Mr. Harada, please.
Thank you. Kemuchi and konnichiwa. Sorry, I wasn't prepared to make a speech at this moment, but first I like to speak in Japanese a little bit and then the English, not Gujarati. Isamoto Kobe Sho, Adachi Kobe Shi, Shigikai Gicho, それに安井、神戸インド日本友好協会会長、さらには、50社、まあ、50名以上の神戸の起業家、それから関係者の皆様、ようこそアーメダバードにいらっしゃいました。ぜひ、アーメダバードの様子を見ていただいてですね、日本に仕事を持って帰っていただかなくてもいいですけれども、アーメダバードの良さ、それから問題、これをぜひ日本に持ち帰っていただきたいと思います。ムケシパテルさんをはじめ、こちらの日本インド協会の方々、それからもちろんモディ首相、それから安倍首相、この両首脳のバックアップはありますが、やはり市のリーダーシップ、それから起業家の皆さんの努力、これがやはり大きな経済を動かす力になるものと思っております。そういう意味でぜひこの短い滞在ですが、いろんなことを見ていただいて日本に持って帰っていただければと思います。Now I would like to speak in Japanese 1 minute. The shorter the better, they say the speech. Congratulations on the Ahmedabad and Kobe sister city relations. I think this is one of the best bilateral sistership relationship, not only India, but in the world. The reason why I said because of the Prime Minister Modi and Prime Minister Abe's support, yes, that's true. But I think it's mostly to the leadership of the Kobe city and leadership of Ahmedabad city, together with the corporate people's efforts to move the relationship ahead. So I would like the delegation headed by the mayor of Kobe, Hisamoto, and other business leaders to see Gujarat, Ahmedabad, and their advantages and problems. Then they talk each other and make business, make even more business. Gujarati are famous for businessmen. Mumbai is controlled by Gujarati. And Gujarati has a great economic establishment in Kobe. I am not from Kobe city, I am from Okayama city. I was with the Okayama City Council President just before getting on the flight. So I came to Ahmedabad because Mukesh Patel-san would kill me if I didn't make the flight this afternoon to be in time for this session. So I really like you to see the best of Gujarat, Ahmedabad, and bring the best back to Japan, forget the problems. So thank you very much for inviting, and all the best for your mission and your dialogue. Thank you.
Thank you, Arada-san, for complimenting city of Ahmedabad for their business sense and business acumen. And I would agree with you because 150 years ago, business people from Gujarat, they started their stay in Japan and particularly in city of Kobe. Last time when we were in city of Kobe, Mukesh Bhai, you will agree that we could meet a lot of Gujarati people who are well settled in their business. So it is a unique combination of Japanese business dynamism and Gujarati business acumen, which is coming out of Ahmedabad. And while Honorable Mayor mentioned about dynamism of Kobe, we would very much assure you that any such gesture, any such initiative from your end will definitely be reciprocated by all of us, and we will make sure that this relationship goes many, many notches above. Now we have one of the success stories in Gujarat, and in particular, this company was set up in Ahmedabad, and this will be complementing the view of Mr. Toyofuku, what he said about mid-sized companies coming to India, coming to establish their business. So I would very much love to invite Mr. Shushunke Ire, the chairman of Fuji Silver Tech Private Limited. May I invite him to give his presentation? Thank you very much.
どうも皆さんこんにちは。グジャラートに会社を出しまして、5年、なりました。富士コンクリートの入江と申します。海外に会社を出してですね、中小企業がやってるということで、多分皆さん英語を喋れんじゃないかというふうに思われるかもしれませんけども、とてもここで喋れるような英語でありませんので、今日は日本語で、話をさせてもらいたいと思います。通訳をちょっと狩谷さんのいいですか。でまずですね、皆さんに最初に謝らなきゃならないのはですね、今週の日曜日に日本から九州から私やってまいりまして、2日前にこの会のことをお聞きいたしました。で最初聞いた時はですね、神戸から日本の方が20名ぐらいいらっしゃるので、その前で今の現状を日本語で話してくれというようなことを言われましたので、それぐらいだったらいいよという話だったんですけども、今日この会場に来ましたら、市長さんをはじめてですね、なんか議員バッジをつけた方がですね、前に座られて、すごい会に来てしまったなというのは正直なところで、まずうちの会社のですね、インドのビデオを少し見ていただいてですね、少しこうイメージをつけてもらえればというふうに思います。あと先ほど豊福さんから話がありました、豊田実社長も今日一緒に来てもらってますので、豊田社長は英語で話せますので、豊田さんすいませんけども、ちょっと簡単に英語でお願いいたします。
はじめまして、東京から来ております、トヨタ工機の豊田と申します。Now we are introduced about the SME company joint venture 50-50 Japanese and India, Fuji Silver Tech, the promotion video, please see it.
A new world economic order is in the making, with India at the heart of it. India is poised to become the world's largest economy by 2030. To support a large-scale economy, a country needs a strong infrastructure backbone. As per one statistic, the required investments in the Indian infrastructure market is projected to be worth 50 trillion rupees by 2022.But it needs to be emphasized that good quality infrastructure is important not only for fast economic growth, but also to ensure its longevity. This is where we step in. We are Fuji Silver Set Group, Japan's leading precast concrete manufacturing company with an installed capacity of 10,14,000 tons per annum. We have over 50 years of rich experience in design, development and manufacturing of high quality precast concrete products. Our production unit based out of Ahmedabad, Gujarat, sprawls across 1.5 million square feet with a wide range of precast products for stormwater, sewage, bridge and culvert, boundary walls, irrigation plants, rail, etc. We want to make sure that the infrastructure we build today is the legacy we leave to future generations. Our products are designed and developed as per Japanese Industrial Standards or JIS, which are considered most stringent standards even amongst the other developed nations. At Fuji Silver Tech, we emphasize on quality, the single most essential element behind our ability to deliver extraordinary products which can stand the test of time. That is the reason why we are trusted by the best. We are building smart infrastructure. That's future ready.
これが会社案内になります。我が社はですね、九州の佐賀県の武雄市というところに本社がありまして、社員数は100名、売上が20億の本当に小さな会社であります。まあ、その小さな会社がですね、なぜこのインド、そしてアーメダバードに会社を出したのかということですけども、ここにいる豊田さんがですね、本当に6年前にこのアーメダバードで3代目の社長としてやっておりましたブリディッシュ社という、今の富士シルバーテックの社長ですけども、彼が日本のプレキャスト工場を見たいと。いうことで日本に来たときにうちの会社を見学に来ました。で、まあ、うちの会社がですね、日本の工場で特殊なコンクリートを使って無振動コンクリートというバイブレーターをかけないコンクリートだったんですけども、まあ、その技術を見て、彼がぜひこの技術をインドでやりたいと教えてくれないかというのが初めでした。で、まあ、その時はじゃあ君の会社の工場を見せてほしいと、まあ、僕もインドに観光か方々ですね、来たのがきっかけ で彼の会社を見せてもらった時に、まあ、正直言いまして、まあ、日本の本当50年前の会社、もうすべてがこう手作業で人力でやっているような会社で、まあ、とてもそこでそのレベルの高いですねコンクリートをやるのは非常に難しいという話をしましたところ、彼がそれでは入江さんの会社がアーメダバードに出てくれということを彼が言いまして、で、まあ、私も初めてこちらの方にお邪魔させてもらってですね、まあ、インドの現状を見たときに、本当に日本の50年前ぐらいのインフラの整備、まあ、トイレもまだ水洗でありませんし、まあ、道路も主要幹線は舗装されておりますけども、もう地方に行ったら舗装もされてないような状況で、まあ、我が社はですね、今年50年になるんですけども、まあ、日本もですねインフラ整備がどんどん進んでいるときには我が社が作っているようなコンクリート製品は非常にこう使われたわけですけども、バルブル崩壊後ですね、見事に売上の方が下がってまいりまして、まあ、最盛期には200名、売上40億ぐらいあったんですけども、見事なぐらい右肩下がり、航空予算が減る中で、売上すべて下がってきたと、まあ、そんな中でやはりこのまま行くと会社が潰れてしまうという危機感を持っていたんですけども、何の手も打てないで、まあ、十数年経った時に、まあ、そういうインドからの話があり、アーメダバードに初めて来たときにですね、まあ、そういう一緒にやらないかという、その言葉が、私自身はものすごいこうビッグチャンスをもらったなということでですね、まあ、正直言って1週間でよし、進出しようというのを決めて日本に帰りました。まあ、帰ってから日本の社員にですね、話をするわけですけども、まあ、そんなこと誰一人思ってなかったわけですけども、いや、進出するぞと。まだまだは我が社がですね作る製品がインドというところでは活躍できる場がものすごくあると、まあ今現在でもですね感覚的には日本の もう1000倍ぐらいの、なんていうんですかね、仕事量が、我々に関する仕事量があると、まあ、そこで一つこう勝負をかけてみようじゃないかということを社員たちに話をしまして、まあ、おかげさまで多くの社員がそのことにですね、賛同してもらって、今日に至っているわけです。1年目はですね、もちろん工場立ち上げということで、売り上げはなかったですけども、まあ、2年目から売り上げが実質的には4億ルピーぐらいありまして、で3年目の実質3年目で、11億ルピーで、まあ、今期も 8% ぐらいの伸びで、おかげさまで予想よりも、まあ、かなりの伸びをさせていただいております。まあ、いろんなですね、問題は非常にあるわけですけども、過去5年間を振り返ってみると、まあ、インド人と一緒にこうビジネスをするっていうのはですね、まあ、最初は非常にこう戸惑いもあったわけですけども、まあ、最初のこう契約の時はですね、すごくディスカッションしました。まあ、契約書を作るまでに私も毎月来まして、1週間ぶっ通しで議論をしながらアグリメントを作って、なかなか合意まで行くにはですね、本当数ヶ月かかったわけですけども、ただ合意したら彼らは、シェイクハンドしたらね、絶対こう、なんていうんですかね、信頼を持って話さないという国民性、本当に信用をしてくれまして、まあ、中国人はよくですね、すぐシェイクハンドするけども、すぐ話すということを聞きますけども、まあ、インドの国民性ではですね、なかなか信用はしてくれないですけども、一度信用してくれるとですね、本当に裏切ることがないというのはですね、この5年間で実感をしております。で、まあ、日本人の特質としましてはですね、まあ、知ってても知らないふりするとか、まあ、持っていても持ってないっていう、そういうなんていうんですね、そういうことがもう美徳みたいな感じであるんですけども、インド人っていうのはその正反対で、まあ、知らなくても知っている、持ってなくても持っている、できなくてもできるという、本当にこう日本人とインド人がこう正反対で、逆にそれがまあうまくいっているところなのかなと、まあインド人のこうアクティビティさとですね、日本人のこう堅実さが、この富士シルバーテックでは非常に今のところうまくいっているのかなという感じを持っております。で、まあ一つだけ皆さんにこうあれなんですけども、まあインドの彼らはですね、いつも何があってもノープロブレムと言います。ノープロブレムさ、ノープロブレムリレーさん、でもそれがプロブレムです。でいつも僕が言うのは、君たちのノープロブレムが一番のプロブレムだと。でもそれは決して悪気があるわけじゃなくて、非常にそういうなんていうんですかね、アクティビ、前向きな考えで仕事にも向かって、そこはもう我々も非常に勉強になりますし、本当に我が社におきましてはですね、この地に工場を出させてもらって、まあ、日本の会社を上回る売り上げが今も現在もできております。全社挙げてですね、まあ我が社が大きくなることがインドが良くなることだというふうに信じてですね、これからも邁進していきたいと思いますし、ぜひ今日いらっしゃる皆さんもですね、まあインドにこう進出をしたいということをお考えでしたら、いろんな経験がありますので、ぜひ聞いていただければ、私が知っていることは全てをお答えしたいというふうに思いますので、よろしくお願いいたします。ありがとうございました。
Thank you very much, Irie-san. The no problem story is so popularly known to all Indians, and we could understand your message loud and clear. But in spite of all the problems, you could have no problem in making your company. You deserve a round of applause for that. Friends, the seminar is going to continue. But as you know, since the time is limited and Mayor Hisamoto has to do many things, including building the sister city relationship, he and the chair, Adachi-san and the consul general, and Yasui-sensei, we will need to leave in the neighboring hall for the media conference. Whereas, and they will be meeting all of us once again at the high tea. And I want to particularly request and invite all delegates. Obviously, the Japanese delegates will be there, but all the Indian and Ahmedabad and Gujarat delegates to please join us in the event we have from 6 to 7:30 after the high tea from 5 to 6, which is a unique program of felicitations to the delegation and perhaps the first of its kind Indo-Japanese musical fusion which is going to be presented. So I'm sure you would all love to be with us until that time, that is 7:30. So with the permission, Yatindra Bhai will please continue the proceedings, and the others who are required to be leaving, we are in the next room. See you again very soon. Please, thank you. Yatindra Bhai.
Thank you, Mukesh Bhai. We continue with the program, and I would like to invite Mr. Arahata, Chief Director, Japan International Trade Organization, Kobe, who is going to give us idea about JETRO activities for attending attracting overseas companies. So may I invite him to make a presentation? Thank you.
Hello.
みなさん、こんにちは。
Hello, everybody. Good afternoon.
神戸から参りました、JETRO 神戸事務所の Arahata と申します。
I come from Kobe and I'm Arahata from JETRO.
本日のこの機会を与えていただきまして、誠にありがとうございます。
And I thank you very much for giving me this opportunity to speak over here.
事務局の方でせっかく通訳の方をご用意いただきましたので、私は通訳の方にお願いして、プレゼンテーションしたいと思います。
And I will be doing the presentation using the services of an interpreter because the office has made arrangements for the interpreter specially for me.
私はインドの企業の方々が日本とビジネスを行う上で、日本に例えば進出するというような時にどのようなお手伝いができるかというお話をしたいと思います。
I will like to inform you that suppose if there are companies in Japan who want to do business in India and want to enter the Indian market, what are the facilities or what help can we give them?
JETRO は日本の政府が設立しました、日本の貿易それから投資を増やすためのそのために作られた機関です。
And JETRO has been established by the Japanese government for encouraging the trade and the investment opportunities for the Japanese businessmen.
世界に54カ国に74の事務所を設置しています。
And with offices in 70 offices in more than 50 countries of the world, JETRO is having.
日本の国内にも現在48の事務所を設けております。
And even in domestically in Japan, we are having 48 offices.
ですので、海外と日本の地方都市を直接橋渡しできる機関というふうになっています。
And that is why we are an organization where you can directly contact us either in the main cities or even in the other small regions.
日本から海外への投資のお手伝いももちろんですけども、海外の企業が日本への投資を関心がある、まあ、そういった企業にも、しっかりとお手伝いをさせていただいています。
Obviously we are also helping companies who are abroad and want to invest in Japan as well.
まず現地のですね、JETRO の事務所の方にご連絡をいただけますと、まずそこの現地の事務所の方で、 ご相談に対応させていただきます。
Firstly, if you contact the JETRO office in, in Japan, then we will definitely give you help from that office.
インドにもですね、JETRO は5カ所事務所がありまして、もちろんここアーメダバードに事務所を設置しております。
And in India also there are 5 JETRO offices, and here in Ahmedabad also we are having the office.
そしてその神戸、私が来ました神戸にも JETRO の事務所がありますので、アーメダバードの事務所と神戸の事務所で連携しながら皆様のビジネスのお手伝いをしていきます。
And since we are also having office in Kobe as well as in Ahmedabad, when the business opportunity is there, we can connect with each other and do the business in, with mutual agreement.
一つはですね、専門家にお願いをしまして、日本の制度についてご説明をさせていただくということを日本ではやっています。
In Japan, we give the advice based on the experts' opinions, and that is why we will give you the information regarding the same.
例えばその企業の投資日本に投機をするときにどういう手続きをしなきゃいけないかですとか、ビザを取るにはどうしたらいいか、まあ、そういったところの専門的なご相談もちゃんと英語で対応させていただいています。
And mainly in English, we will be giving you advice regarding what is the procedure to be followed for getting the visa, or if you want to do investment in Japan, what are the proceedings, all that information or advice we can give you all.
もう一つは、temporary office の提供ということで、営業日の50日間は無料で事務所をオフィスをお貸ししております。
And for 50 business days, we give free of charge advice for you all.
それから兵庫県神戸市こちらの事務所自治体もですね、有事のためにいろいろこう支援策がありますので、JETRO としてもそこと自治体と連携をしながら皆様のお手伝いをしていきます。
And we provide information on various topics from various regions because we are having local offices also in different regions in Japan.
また日本に出た後もですね、しっかりフォローアップ、フォローしていきますので、何か問題があればすぐにご相談に乗れるようにもしております。
And even after coming to Japan, if you are having any problems, then that also we are ready to give you advice for solution of those problems.
JETRO のホームページの方にはですね、日本に投資をする際のさまざまな情報がここから無料でどなたでもご覧いただくことができます。
And if you see the homepage of JETRO, then without any charge, you can get a lot of information regarding investing in Japan.
日本の制度がどうなっているかとかですね、そういったところの基礎的な情報はこのウェブサイトから見ることができると思います。
That's why if you visit the website, then you can get the basic information, all the basic information regarding investing in Japan.
また産業別の情報、日本の産業がどう今どんな状況になっているかとかですね、そういった経済情報、産業情報、これも、このウェブサイトから無料でどなたでもご覧いただくことができます。
And also information relating to the various industries or various businesses, you can get free from this website.
それでは新しいビジネスをですね、日本に持ち込んでいただくというのはもう大歓迎ですので、ぜひ日本での投資ということもご検討いただければというふうに思います。
And that is why we will give you a very big welcome if you are intending to start up a business in Japan. And that is why we will give you full-hearted, wholehearted support for starting a business and investing in Japan. You all are welcome.
市長のお話もありましたけども、神戸は医療産業都市として、医療関係の企業、研究所、病院が集積をしています。
And especially in Kobe, there is a lot of scope for pharmaceutical or business related to medicine and healthcare.
こういったところとですね、共同で新しいビジネスを開拓していただくということもいいんではないかというふうに思います。
And that is why I think that if we mutually understand each other and take the advice from the consultants, then we can definitely do well in this business.
ぜひ神戸の方にお越しください。
That's why I once again welcome you to Kobe.
まず神戸の方に、ご関心のある方はですね、まずJETRO のアーメダバードの事務所の方に、こちら、住所、電話番号を書いておきましたので、ご連絡いただければというふうに思います。
And that's why any companies in Ahmedabad who are interested in coming to Kobe and doing business, you can contact the JETRO office which is there in Ahmedabad and there is the telephone number also mentioned over here.
どうもありがとうございました。Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Arata-san, to give an idea about JETRO activities worldwide and in particular India, and particularly with the city of Kobe. We would be very much interested to get in touch with you for the future opportunities. Thank you very much. And may I request all of you to give him a big round of applause. Thank you. Now, this is from our side to give an idea about what kind of business opportunities are available in Gujarat. And government of Gujarat is dynamically associated with industries of Gujarat, and they have been playing a very, very proactive role to create very encouraging and conducive environment for doing business in Gujarat. In terms of ease of doing business, which is a survey by World Bank of, you know, World Bank Worldwide, the survey has been done by them every year for India, and in ease of doing business, Gujarat has been ranked first when the first survey was done, and even today it is in the forefront. So I would like to invite Mr. Paresh Penley from the Industries Commissionerate Office to give us a presentation on opportunities in Gujarat. Mr. Paresh, thank you very much.
Good evening, friends, and konnichiwa. Mukesh Patel-san has already mentioned, Industries Commissioner Dr. Rahul Gupta was supposed to make this presentation, but as he has to be with the Chief Minister for meeting with the His Excellency Ambassador of Japan in India, Suzuki-san, he is there in Gandhinagar, so I am presenting on his behalf. This is a video presentation of opportunities that Japanese companies have to invest in Gujarat. I would seek your attention on this video.
Gujarat, the fastest growing state in India. Gujarat, the land of leaders. Gujarat, the growth engine of India. Gujarat, an investment in prosperity. With a contribution of 7.7% share in the national GDP and its own growth rate of 13%, Gujarat is one of the best performing economy in India. It has the highest industrial output of 16.8% according to the annual survey of industries 2016-17 and highest FDI inflow at 39.46% in the country reported in the first quarter of 2019. Gujarat, with 45% share in the manufacturing sector, is a national leader in chemicals and petrochemicals, dairy, drugs and pharmaceuticals, cement, textiles, engineering, gems and jewelry, and ceramics.
We believe in reforms and are driven by progressive policies. Our state ranks high in ease of doing business, in economic freedom, and in investment potential.
This consistent progress has been possible because of the state's focus on developing the four P's, namely place, policies, people, and planet. The place. The state boasts of 6 smart cities, 18 domestic and 5 international airports, 5,000 kilometers of railway, and 1,63,000 kilometers of highways. Delhi-Mumbai Industrial Corridor, DMIC, and Dedicated Freight Corridor, DFC. 41 ports along the longest coastline in the country, which handle 40% of country's cargo and 20.4% of total exports. A statewide natural gas grid, the nation's largest LNG terminal, as well as statewide water grid. Uninterrupted quality power supply across 24/7. Dholera Special Investment Region, DSIR. Largest ever industrial land in Southeast Asia with dedicated international airport. Gift City, the first such place in India that offers state-of-the-art infrastructure to IT and financial services. Gujarat Industrial Development Corporation, GIDC, the industrial land bank of the government of Gujarat, has developed special investment regions, SIRs, and petroleum, chemicals, and petrochemicals investment regions, PCPIRs. That is why Gujarat was awarded the state with best infrastructure at the India Today State of State Conclave 2018 and ranked the number one on the Logistics Performance Index and Leeds Index 2019. The policies. Gujarat is a policy-driven state. It enables its investors with a single window clearance system and investor facilitation portal to process the applications in time-bound manner. The state's grievances redressal committees across departments maintain transparency and accountability in the system. The progress is consistently monitored by the Honorable Chief Minister himself through CMO dashboard. As part of ease of doing business, it provides exemption of max up to 3 years from certain approvals and inspections for establishment and operation of MSMEs. As a result, Gujarat leads the nation in MSMEs and is ranked the number one in all India states' startup ranking. Gujarat also ranked the first in the number of IEMs filed with 50% of total proposed investment within India. And it stands the first in the number of IEM implemented with 39.5% across India. The state accounts for 22.7% of private corporate investment and is home to the most successful brands. The people. Gujarat, the largest human capital base, is home to 5% of India's population, 60% of which is working population, and 43% is the urbanized population. Gujarat houses best education facilities in the country, like IIM Ahmedabad, ranked the first, IIT, NID, IRMA, and iCreate. Gujarat also generates skilled labor force in excess of 20 million through vocational training institutes and centers of excellences. Gujarat is also synonymous with high labor peace and robust law and order situation for conducive investment environment. The Right of Citizens Act empowers the citizens to access services and information seamlessly. Gujarat State offers advanced healthcare with super and multi-speciality hospitals and has emerged as a hub of medical tourism. Gujarat is not only economically progressive state, but also a forward-looking state in terms of a vibrant social life. The planet. Gujarat stands for sustainable and inclusive development with its commitment to have a green and sustainable planet. Hence, it established first ever climate change department, not only in India, but in Southeast Asia. Gujarat is also ranked the number one in Composite Water Management Index 2019. Gujarat stands for its commitment for the increased use of renewable and solar energy through sponsoring many schemes like the Gujarat Solar Scheme, solar parks, and wind farms. The state already has one of the biggest solar parks in the country at Charanka, which is built on 2,000 hectares of plot. And it is in process of building a bigger plant of 5,000 megawatt capacity at Dholera SIR, which will be spread over 8,600 hectares. By investing in the place, the policies, the people, and the planet, Gujarat has reaped profit, progress, peace, and prosperity. Because when you invest in Gujarat, you invest in prosperity.
Thank you very much for your attention. I'll be more than happy to answer any questions if you have. So feel free to ask any questions later in the end. Thank you very much, and arigato gozaimasu. Yes. We'll take questions later. Let us finish with this thing. We'll take questions later.
Thank you, Paresh, for such an interesting introduction of business acumen and business development in Gujarat. I would invite Okada-san for conducting one activity where we would like to request our delegation members to make a short introduction to audience, whereby they can have networking at a later point. Because the idea of such gathering is just not getting any information, but also to create networking for opportunities in the future. So may I invite Okada-san to help me to do this session. So may I invite delegation members to come and present themselves. Short introduction, preferably in English, otherwise maybe an interpreter can help us.
それではすいません、その場で立ってちょっとお名前とちょっとした説明をしていただくということだと思ってたんですけれども、ちょっとこの場にですね来ていただいて、一人ずつ簡単に紹介してて戻っていただくような形にお願いしますということなので、そのようにさせていただきたいと思います。団長と副団長はちょっと別会場におりますので、残りの方 のご紹介ということで、まずすいません、大森海藻店の須藤様、すいません、よろしくお願いいたします。通訳も入れておりますので。Yeah, sure.近くて結構ですので。はい、すいません。
Yeah. Well, Japanese or English, well, in order to shorten the time, I will speak in my poor English, okay? My name is Akihiko Sudo. Well,Thank you very much for taking the time today for us today. It is my pleasure to attend this wonderful seminar in Ahmedabad. Okay, let me introduce my company. My company's name is Omori Kaisoten. Omori Kaisoten was founded at 1873, six years after the opening of the Kobe port. And now we are acting at the freightwater and warehousing and also international transportation. And now we are continuing the business with the growing of the port of Kobe. Now we are having a subsidiary company in China and Southeast Asian countries, and 6 years ago we had a joint venture company in Delhi in India. But my company at the small and medium sizes, Mr. Toyofuku said, but at the moment the evaluation of the success of the investment in Delhi were notis not certain at the moment, but in the future, to attend this seminar, the goodness of Ahmedabad, I was recognition. So in the future, our company in India will expand it to Ahmedabad.Thank you very much.
と続きまして若松社長お願いできますでしょうか。
So my name is Wakamatsu in Kawanishi Warehouse Company in Kobe. So I speak Japanese.
私の会社は管理倉庫と言いまして、主な仕事は、倉庫、それからあとウェアハウス&コールドストレージ&カスタムブローカー&ロジティクス、が、それでですね、国内、ジャパン、インジャパンですね、国内に、30カ所の倉庫があります。
Our company is mainly involved in warehousing and cold storage, and we also do custom broking, brokers. So, in domestically in Japan, we have warehouses in 30 places.
海外ではですね、東南アジアを中心に、青島、それから上海、香港、それとサンフランシスコに、我々の拠点があります。
And in overseas also, we are having warehouses in various places like Chinatown, Shanghai, Hong Kong, etc.
今特に海外で力を入れてますのは実はインドではなくてですねインドネシアでございます。
And actually now, right now we are putting our efforts actually not in India but in Indonesia.
Very sorry. So, Very sorry. インドネシアで3年前に、コールドストレージ、コールドチェーンを開始いたしました。
Okay. And in Indonesia, 3 years ago, we have started with cold chain related to cold storage.
はい。それで、今年、来月2月に、フェーズ2のコールドストレージを、今やろうとしております。
Sorry. And now in February, we are planning to do cold storage phase 2.
大きさはですね、約全部で2万3000パレットの大きさのオートマティカリーのコールドストレージが2年後に完成する予定であります。
And we are having the size, we are planning to have a size of 23,000 pallets and we'll complete that in a period of 2 years.
今回インドは初めてでして、まあ、我々が海外に進出にあたりまして、まあ、まずインドを見たいということで、このチャンスを、いただきましたので、やってきました。
And we are having overseas in Indonesia, but India for the first time we are coming, and that's why in the first place I would like to see and understand India before having a presence in India.
短い間ですけれども、インドをしっかり見てですね、何かご協力できることがあればと思っておりますので、ぜひよろしくお願いいたします。
Yeah, and definitely, but I would love to have a relationship and promotion of economic promotion in India. Thank you very much.
はい、ありがとうございました。
続きまして、神組の秋山さんは別のお部屋に行かれてますかね。そうしましたら、ソマ様と大神様、サンビルダー、お二人でじゃあ、大神様、はい、ソマ様。
My name is Koji Soma. I'm from Kobe. My business is a rental apartment business in Kobe area. We have 80 sites apartments in Kobe area. And the sale ofOur rental fee is a billion yen. And I started 50 years ago, my company established. That meaning 49 years after the establishment of my company. And I started as a salesman of real estate.And start to the wooden house selling. And next, we start to the condominium sales in Japan. But we stopped that business 15 years ago. I focused to the rental business now. Then I'm looking forward to have a chance to own some apartments or land in foreign countries. And this time we came. The reason why we came, my son and I. Because I'm now 60 8 years old. My son is 31, and elder son is 32. They are very young. Then 30 years or 20 years future, we look forward. Then the reason why I came here. Thank you.
続きまして、シスメックスのオート様、アニュー様で一緒に。
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Satoru Oto. Come from Sysmex. I'm a Kobe citizen, but currently I'm stationed in Singapore. Sysmex is the manufacturer for the medical device and the diagnostic reagent. And we made a presence in India almost 25 years ago, together with the India local partners. We could quite good success to grow the business in India. However, in order to contribute more healthcare improvement in India under the Modi care, so I am quite interested in to find any opportunities to run the business together with you. Thank you very much.
すいません。アロン・ダスワニさんはいらっしゃらないですよね。ダスワニさん、いらっしゃらない。失礼しました。
Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Arun Daswani from DVD Limited Japan. We are a 50-year-old. I'm personally born and brought up in Japan, lived all my life over there, and my company is over 50 years, by the name of DVD Limited. We are handling joint venture technical collaborations as one of our segments. Another segment is environmental technology. Number three, we do secondary and raw materials from Japan. And fourth, we do confectionaries. And the last, we do film distribution. So basically, I export a lot from Japan. My imports are currently just films and like TV contents, which I import from India, and I sell in Japan. So if you all have any queries afterwards, feel free to get in touch with me. Thank you very much.
じゃあ続きまして、物理倉庫の川村様お願いします。
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is 川村 of Mitsubishi Logistics Company, Kobe Branch.
どうしようかな、日本語でやろうかな。
We established 1887, and we have five business menu. One is warehousing, two is inland transportation, three is harbor transportation, for example, operating in the container yard. Four is international transportation. We have many offices worldwide, around 20 countries. And five is real estate business. We have a shopping center in Harbor Land in Kobe. We have one office in India at Delhi. Thank you very much.
そしたら川西様、モレスコさん代表してお願いします。
I'll be using the interpreter and I'll be speaking in Japanese.
私どもの会社は神戸に本拠地を持っておりますモレスコという特殊潤滑油とホットミルク接着剤をメインとしたメーカーでございます。
So our company's head office is in Kobe and we are mainly involved in hot melt adhesives and lubricants.
海外はタイ、中国、アメリカ、あとインドネシアに続く5カ国目の拠点としてインドが昨年の7月から創業しております。
So we are mainly having our locations in Thailand, China, America and Indonesia. And from January we have started it.
こちらのインドでは、先ほど申し上げました特殊潤滑油、主に自動車用のダイキャスト用の潤滑油ですね。それと、
And mainly our product is the lubricant oil used in the automobile for die-cast purposes.
あと、ホットメント接着剤は主に紙おむつとかに使用する衛生材料用の接着剤を生産しています。
And hot melt is basically used for drying of paper and so on.
まだ立ち上がって、まだ日系さんとの取引がメインとなっておりますけど、まあ、アクティブなこのインドの市場でモレスコの知名度を上げていけるようにやっていきたいと思いますので、よろしくお願いいたします。
And we are really looking forward to have various activities with Moresco India as well. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
次は山本電機、山本社長様。
どうも皆様こんにちは。
Good afternoon, everybody.
山本電機製作所の山本と申します。
I'm Mr. Yamamoto.
弊社は、微差圧計、マイクロディファレンシャルプレッシャーセンサー、微差圧計という特殊な産業用の、センサーを作っています。
My company is engaged into micro differential sensors, which is specific type of sensors.
主に、半導体製造装置並びにクリーンルームなどで使われる商品です。
Basically, it is used in clean rooms for mainly used in semiconductor areas.
第2の事業の柱として川崎重工さんメインなんですが、ガスタービンエンジンの周辺機器、こちらの方も作っております。ガスタービンエンジン、ペリフェラル、
はい、で
をメーカー。
So we are the makers of gasoline engine.
はい。で先ほどの、プレッシャーセンサーは、バンガロール、インドではバンガロールの方に、出荷している実績があります。
And the pressure sensors which I talked about, we are mainly delivering it to Bangalore in India.
今後も、インドの産業がどんどん発展していって、きれいな、空気、それから半導体が必要な工場がどんどんできることがあれば、弊社の商品もどんどん売れていくことだろうと思います。
And even in near future, I'm expecting that more and more clean air will be required, and that's why wherever the semiconductors are required, please contact our company.
どうぞよろしくお願いいたします。ありがとうございました。
続きまして和光技研の岩崎様。
Good evening, everybody. My name is Ryuji Iwasaki, and our company's name is Wako Giken Company Limited. established in Kyoto City about 60 years ago, and we are manufacturing independent electronic generation system and energy storage devices and microgrid system and solar power stations. I'm not good at speaking English, so from now on in Japanese.当社はもともとエンジニアリングの会社で、建設機械のメカトロニクス化などを手掛けてきました。
Mainly our company is an engineering company and we are manufacturing the machinery for the construction.
そして50年以上にわたって、パナソニックの下請けとして、電子制御回路の設計開発などを行ってきました。
And for more than 50 years, we have been taking subcontractors contractorship from Panasonic, and we have been doing design and development for them.
というわけで、安く早く品質よく作るという技術を学んできましたので、インドの社会に適したあるいはニーズに合ったものをエンジニアリングの会社として開発していくということができると思いますので、何か要望がありましたらよろしくお願いします。
And basically, we are skilled at developing cheap, fast, and quality goods, and we are having technology for that, which is suiting perfectly to the needs of India. That's why, especially with respect to engineering products and development, if you got anything, please contact my company.
Thank you very much.
神戸大学の吉井先生は、あ、そちら続きまして、矢橋さんお願いします。
ナマステ。My name is Hajime Yabase. NPO organization is an energy and environment network. Next is a president. It is an environmental organization for the business matching. So, for example, is a solar thermal use.Save energy system or waste heat usage, save energy system. And other system is also air pollution for PM 2.5 filter and wastewater treatment system for using bio tank.So I want to introduce Japanese environmental technology to introduce to Indian market and some business and consultant, I hope. Thank you very much.
Sato Center 長いらっしゃいますか。上原理事長、あ、富永さんをよろしくお願いします。失礼しました。
ナマステ。
私は一応商社をやっておりまして、仕事内容としては、まあ、今とインドに来て車などたくさん見させてもらったんですけども、走ってる車はやっぱり韓国製、日本製のスズキとかヒュンダイとかたくさん走ってるんですけども、そういった設備を作る時の工作機械。
So basically, when we see in India, we see the cars mainly of Japan make, Korea make, like we have Toyota and Hyundai and so on. And my company is into mechanical equipment manufacture.
そういった工作機械が日本では必ず10年、20年ごとに新しい設備を導入するためにそれが必要なくなる形が出てきます。
And basically this heavy machinery which we are manufacturing, so in Japan around 10 to 20 years ago such machinery was required when we are installing new installations and new equipments.
そういう設備を私は今現在中国、韓国、あとベトナム、東南アジアの方に流しております。
And currently I'm exporting all this machinery to China, Korea and Southeast Asia.
で今後インドのお客様と一緒に何かご協力できればと思いますので、何かありましたらよろしくお願いいたします。
And I'm looking forward to economic cooperation with Indians also as well. So from now onwards, let's have more and more economic cooperation. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. This is all the our delegation member, which is the, our delegation business member from our business mission.
Thank you, Okada-san. I think now it is time for question answers. So may I request people to ask questions? No questions.
Good evening. I am Rajkumar Oswal, Director of Toyota Forms India and Fuji Silvertech. I have about 15 to 20 people, Japanese people working with me. And the best and the worst experience I had, what about Japanese language, speaking to in English. Most important thing for you and the most problematic thing is communication with Indian people. Toyofuku-san, I've been associated with him. He's one of the responsible person for me to get involved with.Toyota and Fuji. The most important thing out of three you have mentioned, the fourth one is language. I think I request all the Kobe and all the Japanese visitors who are coming, please spend some time in learning English. Without that, it is not possible easily. It takes a lot of time. He has said, involve some good Indian people, partner from in Ahmedabad. But they also cannot speak good English. That is the unfortunate part of it.
So the we also cannot speak good Japanese, but point is that essence of business cooperation is to learn about each other. And I would agree with you that language is one of the critical aspect of interacting with people. I mean, as simple as that. And as that particular initiative part, we already have a Japanese language academy at Ahmedabad Management Association. And...We have trained by now more than 500 students, and we also have a Japanese teacher supported by JICA. So that is something, an opportunity available to people from Gujarat. And while our Japanese friends, I think many of them have tried to speak them in English, I think I would request all of you to give them a big round of applause. And I think language is something which we learn with each other when we start interacting on a continuous basis. I will give you a very interesting example. I run a German joint venture company. And we started manufacturing a machine in India of a German technology. Now my German colleagues were not knowing Indian language or even English. And my boys were not knowing German. But we understood German drawings very well. But while working together for 12 weeks, my team and their team, both of them, they created a very good understanding and we built the machine. We didn't know German and they didn't know English. Still it is possible. So point is that yes, it does help to know the language because that is one of the barrier. But at the same time, I think people from Gujarat, they don't need any recipe for that because they were the people who brought Portuguese people to India. When Portuguese trademen, seafarer Vasco da Gama wanted to come to India, from port of Mombasa to Indian port of Cochin, he was a Gujarati businessman who brought him to India. So point is that language, yes, I do agree, and we are putting efforts to provide such help to our people where they can learn Japanese language very well. Any other question?
It's a time being phase now. Google translation. Even the interpreter requirement is not required if it is taken. And it's very easy. And that problem will be solved in a couple of years only, world over. With different so many languages and so many, even from Gujarati to Japanese also, it can translate.
Yes, yes.
Yes.
Not only verbally, yeah, but audio.
Audio, written, and communication also. The moment you speak, immediately it will translate to the other language.
So anyway, we will have Google Translator audio with us all the time when we talk to our Japanese friends.
And only thing what we require is to get accustomed to the new technology. Thank you.
Great. Thank you very much. Any other question?
It's not really a question. My name is Kei Taomi. I work at the Ahmedabad University addressing that issue, language communication issue. We develop Japanese language course as well as MA. So about 120 students sign up for class, and we have a teaching assistant here, Manshi. So, I mean, we're going to discipline students. We're going to teach Japanese using the Google translation. That'll be great. And then, so yeah, I just want to say thank you so much for this great opportunity. I have a lot of cards. If you want to just reach out to me, my name is Kei Taomi. Ahmedabad 大学で教員をしている大見啓太と申します。社会科学、政治科学を専攻で研究、教員をやってます。まあ、それと加えて日本語講座の開設、うちの大学で今学期から初めてやることになりましたんで、日本語教育合わせて、まあインドの人材教育に力を入れていこうと思ってますので、もし何か力になれることがあればよろしくお願いいたします。Thank you so much.
So friends, we had a wonderful seminar and I'm really delighted to host our business leaders and also our leaders from Kobe City and people from JETRO. I think we had a wonderful interaction. We tried to present you some of the very interesting aspects. Likewise, it was very interesting for us to know about Kobe City, its pioneering role into many areas, sectors. We also knew about JETRO, how they are helping out various industries from Japan to come to India, and maybe Indian companies to go to Japan. And very, very aptly mentioned by our JETRO Ahmedabad chief, that he never said that there will be, I mean, they started with three Japanese people, but now there are many, many more Japanese families in city of Ahmedabad. You also have nice 10 golf courses in Ahmedabad. So if at all you have passion for golf, you can always unwind and enjoy. And the way in which business cooperation is something which is people-to-people contact. And we are fortunate to host you, 51 of you, together with the Honorable Mayor of Kobe City. It's a great compliment from all of you. And we have tried to present you the success story of a Japanese company, very much in Ahmedabad, by a Japanese entrepreneur. So that will give you enough opportunity to reflect and evaluate. Also, we have tried to give you an overview, a panoramic overview of Gujarat as an industrial hub of India. And we had greetings from Consul General. In all, it has been a wonderful meeting with all of you. First of all, I would like to thank you all for being with us this day, I mean right from morning itself. And also I thank all our guests who spoke on various topics. Wonderful gathering, wonderful discussions. And thanks to you all, and thank you all to see you again. But small request to our people that there is a high tea downstairs near the auditorium where you can have high tea and then the next program will start. Thank you so much. Thank you very much.